Welcome to Algorithms with Professor Califf. Today I'd like to talk to you about insertion sort. So the basic idea behind insertion sort is that we're going to divide our list in an array, usually, into two parts. One part will be sorted and the other part will be unsorted. Then we're going to insert items from the unsorted list into the correct location in the sorted list. So we'll move things from the unsorted part to the sorted part, putting each of them in order. So once we've got the last item from the unsorted list into the correct location, our whole array will be sorted. So how are we going to do this? We can just take the first item in the list and say, you're sorted. Any item all by itself is by definition sorted. There's nothing to be out of order here. The first item is a sorted list. The rest of it is the unsorted list. We're going to take our algorithm. It's going to be a nested loop. So the outer loop will walk through that unsorted list from the first item to the last item. And for each of those, the inner loop is going to go find the right place to insert the item in the sorted list, moving any values out of the way that it needs to. So let's go through this with our example. First pass through the outer loop is going to insert the 7. So we save off the 7 and say, okay, this is the value we're inserting. And right now we're at 1. We see that the 7 is smaller than the 13. So we move the 13 out of the way. And then we put the 7 in place. And as soon as we've put the item in place, it becomes part of the sorted list. Everything from 0 to 1 is now sorted. We're at our second pass. So the value we're inserting now is 9. And we're starting with J is 2 in our inner loop. So now we walk backwards, move the 13 out of the way because 9 was smaller than the 13. We see that with the next thing, the 7, the 9 is not smaller than the 7. So we put the 9 in place. It belongs here. And we go on to tackle the next item to insert. So that'll be the 2, and we start at 3, of course. So we start checking backwards. The 13 is larger than the 2, so we move it out of the way. Then the 9 was larger than the 2, so we move it out of the way. The 7 is also larger than the 2, so we move it out of the way. Now, at this point, we don't have anywhere else to go because we're at the 0. There's no previous item. So we simply put the 2 in place. So we go to insert the 15. We start with our working backward, and we see immediately that the 13 is not larger than the 15. So the 15 is already where it needs to go in this sorted list. So we leave it in place. And we move on to the next pass. So in this pass, we're going to insert the 10. So the 15 is larger, move it out of the way. The 13 is larger, we move it out of the way. And then the 9 is not larger, so we put the 10 there at the 3. Next pass, we're going to take a look at the 5. 15 is larger, 13 is larger, 10 is larger, 9 is larger, 7 is larger. But at this point, the 2 is not larger, so we put the 5 in its spot at index 1. Then finally, on our last pass, we need to insert the 12. We start looking. The 15 is larger, the 13 is larger, the 10 is not larger, so the 12 will go there at index 5. So let's take a look at what the code looks like. We'll start with the outer loop. So we're going to run from 1, because remember, 0 is where the sorted list is, the one item, and go through all of the values in the unsorted part of the list. So that will end when we run out, whether that's num items or array.length or whatever it may be. So each time through that loop, first we're going to save off what's the value we're inserting right now, because we're going to be overwriting it in the array, most likely. And then we're going to set the counter for our inner loop, our J, to be I, because we're going to be working backward from where that value was. Then we're going to have an inner loop to get J to the right place for us to insert the item. And once that inner loop is over, we're we're just going to put the value we're inserting into that spot that we found. Notice that we don't do swaps in insertion sort. We simply move everything out of the way that needs to be moved and then put the value in place. So then in our inner loop, the job is to get to the right spot while moving all of the items out of the way. So we have two potential conditions for stopping. The first one is that we got down to zero and we need to just put this insert val into that first spot before we run out of array. The other possibility is that we've actually found a case where the insertion value is smaller. So as long as the item we're looking at is bigger than the one we want to insert, then we can go ahead and keep going because the insertion value needs to be further forward in the array. If they're equal or the value in front is smaller, then we need to put insert val here. We do have this as a stable sort, so it's never going to change the order of values. They're the same in terms of their key. So let's think a little bit about the performance of insertion sort. Worst case performance is where we'll start. So that's the case where the array starts in reverse order, the same as, say, our bubble sort, our selection sort. So on the very first pass, we're going to have one comparison and one move. Second pass, we're going to have two items in the sorted part, and so we're going to need to compare to each of those and move them over before we put this item in. Third pass, it'll be three comparisons because there are three items in that sorted list that we've got to move out of the way before we can put this one in. We get to the next to last pass, so it's going to be n minus two, where n is the number of items, comparisons, and that many items to move out of the way. Then on the very last pass, we're going to have n minus one comparisons and moves. So our number of comparisons is 1 plus 2 plus 3 dot 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 until plus n minus 3, n minus 2, plus n minus 1. If we change that slightly so that we have 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus dot 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 n minus 2, n minus 1 plus n, that's equal to n times n plus 1 over 2. And so we can turn that into n times n minus 1 over 2 if we plug in n minus 1 for our n. So what we have here is n squared minus n divided by 2. So when we think about our big O version of that, we have big O of n squared. So our worst case performance for insertion sort is n squared. Same as our worst case performance for selection sort, for bubble sort. All of those are called the n squared sorts. Let's also look at the average case. We're going to do about half as many comparisons and moves. That's going to give us a lower constant factor, but we're still looking at big O of n squared. So in the average case and the worst case, we're n squared. So let's consider the best case performance. So this would be when the array is already sorted in the correct order. We just presumably don't know that. There will be no moves because everything's where it goes. We don't have to actually move anything over. Nothing will get out of the way. We're going to have n minus one comparisons. The way that's going to work is we're going to do one comparison for each pass and go, oh, you're smaller than or equal to me. I don't have to do anything. Then with the next item, we'll look at the previous one and go, oh, not going to move in front of you, and so on. So one comparison for each of the n minus one passes that we have in insertion sort. So big O of n. Now this is the same as bubble sort, if you're familiar with that, but it requires less overhead overall. So if we compare to other elementary sorts, insertion sort is the elementary sort of choice. It's always better than bubble sort. While they'll have the same big O analyses, there's simply lower overhead involved in an insertion sort than in a bubble sort. It's almost always better than selection sort. So selection sort is n squared in all cases. It always has to do all the comparisons. It is technically better than insertion sort when the items are completely reversed because it will do less movement than insertion sort will. On the other hand, if you know it's completely reversed, you shouldn't be doing a sort at all. You should just reverse it. Another thing to note about insertion sort is that it regularly gets used as part of more sophisticated sorts. So when we improve a quick sort, we will often use cutoffs and use insertion sort for pieces of it. You see insertion sort as parts of other things. Something called shell sort is based on insertion sort. So insertion sort is really the elementary sort, the n squared sort that you need to know. So make sure you know insertion sort. I hope this was helpful and that you feel like you have some idea of how insertion sort works and perhaps how it relates to the other two elementary sorts. I do have videos on both of those as well if you have questions about those. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.